Because of familiarity, when you're around somebody and you can see all the negative parts of them, your sisters, your brothers,
come on, Apostle.
Your family,
come on, work that thing.
They know you.
Come on now, come on, Apostle.
And sometimes it's hard for them to get past that. Well, you say you was a pastor.
Yeah.
Might have been so 30 minutes.
You are.
And you did this. You did that.
Yes.
And all they could think about is that tape that's playing in their head. But all that foolishness you used to do. And all the stuff that you and them used to do and stealing and doing some of everything you didn't have no business doing.
They won't let that die. Exactly.
One thing, though, about them type relationships, that's why you have to have endurance.
Yes, you do.
And when you realize how important they are, you have to have what you call a mindset to wait for them to develop.
Yes.
Because you'll understand, no, you might not accept me now, but a day is coming that you're going to see me in a whole different light.
Hey, Lord.
And because, you know, we've been together all our life and we've been family all our life, ain't nothing going to change that. But one day you will have appreciation for me.
Yeah.
And if I have to wait for that day, I will. Yeah. Come on, somebody. Now, there's some folk I don't have to wait for that. Y'all ain't talking. Now, maybe my sister, my brother, or somebody, but there's some folk I ain't got to wait for. My close-knit family.
Uh-huh.
Am I right?
Amen.
Even in marriage, we have to be careful because when familiarity set in, it is easy for disrespect to set in.
Oh, yes.
Come on now.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah.
You better say that again.
Get common with them. Come on, Bob.
Disrespect is the thing that kills a marriage.
No, right now. Oh,
my God. Come on.
Disrespect. And I know I'm outnumbered here tonight. Me and we got three men. I gotta be careful what I say. We might get a man out of here. Nah. But you know, the formula says, husband, love your wife as Christ loves the church. Mm-hmm. And women, what? Respect the husband. Mm-hmm. Now, when people sometimes get married, when you're dating, you hide a lot of stuff. That's the truth. You hide about stuff because you don't want nobody to see all your bad stuff.
Yeah.
You hide it. I mean, it's there and you keep it here until you accomplish what you're trying to accomplish. Then when you say I do,
yes, sir.
Next thing you know, it come I don't. Because that first stage is the ecstasy stage where you feel good and you so infatuated till you choose not to see even red flags when they flying up everywhere.
That's right.
You be like, oh, I don't see that. All you see is that your mind is clouded with the effects of love.
That's right. Amen.
Come on, man.
Whether it's actual or whether it's factual. It, whether it's real or whether it's not, sometimes you're just fascinated.
Amen.
Because of a person's ability of what they could do. It's just like the lady singing, and I mean, she sang, he just fell in love with her singing. And I tell you, boy, he got home, woke up the next day, he looked at her, sang, baby, sang. Y'all didn't catch that, did you?
Yeah.
Because what happened was, after a while, the fascination wore off. And when it wore off, he found out he wasn't in love with her. He was in love with what she could do. Because you'll get tired of what they... After a while, am I talking right? Ooh, it could be rough, y'all. Because see, that ecstasy stage is where you've been all my life and all that good. But then after that, here comes the reality stage. Mm-hmm. Now here comes, say, you know, because when you used to come by his apartment to visit. He kept everything neat, pushed, right? But you thought it was neat. He had a secret mess room. And he said, oh, yeah, this is a neat man, yeah. And he had a messy room that you wouldn't allow to go in. Am I right? There were certain behaviors that were very entertaining to you.
Amen.
But after a while, the mess was uncovered. The behaviors were just camouflages, covering up real behavior. Now, that's the reality stage, but now here comes the challenge stage. The challenge stage is, can I stay here with you and deal with this? Here's the key, though. If you choose to deal with it, you got to keep your respect. Because if you lose respect, you're going to lose your intimacy. If you lose your intimacy, you're going to lose your connection. Are y'all listening to me right now? And when you lose the intimacy, you lose the pleasure of wanting to be with the person.
You talk right, that's right.
And the devil knows how to play with your emotions. That's why it takes a full realm of education now. Come on, somebody. Y'all going to talk. Because marriage is composed of two imperfect people. Ain't neither one of you perfect. And marriage is not supposed to be talking about, I need somebody to complete me.
You better come on, Apostle.
Only God can complete you.
Come on, Apostle. That's right.
Marriage should be two whole people.
That's it.
Coming together.
That's it.
You done learned, am I right? Mm-hmm. You've been watching other folk. Come on, somebody.
Amen. Yeah.
That's the best way to learn.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they're just watching other folk, you know. Disrespect is a serious problem because it will kill the intimacy in any relationship. Am I talking right? That's why I tell folk, that's why you got to keep respect for your master. Sometimes that's not good to be running around calling by their first name all the time.
That's right.
That's true.
Or a nickname, JT. What's going on, JT? Familiarity.
Yeah.
Some people can be around you and still respect you, but there are some people that don't need to be around you.
That's right. Come on
now.
Am I right?
Hello.
Oh, Lord, let me talk. See, in these relationships, you gotta be people around you that is glad for you, people that want to see good things happen for you, people that make good things happen for you. And if that's the case, what will happen is here. Any time you make something good happen for somebody else, God will make something good happen for you. It goes to the law of reciprocity, that you will reap what you sow. Am I right? If you sow acts of kindness to other people, am I right? That's coming back. I don't care how much dirt the devil sent through somebody else. Just wait for it. It's coming back. Might not come back to who you want to come through, but it's coming back. Am I right? Sometimes all the love you get on one person and you want to come back from them, might not come back from them. But trust me, it's coming back. Am I right? That's why sometimes there's some poor God got to move out your life.
That's right. Amen.
Yes.
I wrote a song one time called Taking Up Space. Yeah, Taking Up Space. I forget the name of the song. I wrote that song some years back. Taking up space in my life. You know, see, you got to understand, you can't let folk just take up space.
Yes.
See, when people just take up space, they're there and they ain't really doing nothing. By calling you hell and aggravation. Am I right? And they're taking the space that somebody else needs.
Amen.
Y'all ain't gonna talk right now.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I don't believe that God made us to just be space taker uppers. Just take up space and don't do nothing. Am I right? I need every space of my life filled with people that is active. Come on, somebody. Yes. And helping me to fulfill purpose, and I'm helping them to fulfill purpose. Am I right?
Yes.
That's what you need around your life. That's what you need in your marriage. That's what you need. You have to develop your children like that. Am I right?
Yes.
Your children are instrumental. They might be immature now, but they're going to grow up one day.
Yes.
And it's up to you to parentally instill stuff in them. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
You might think they ain't listening. You might think they ain't get it. But when they get off to college and a demon come up, and they remember, Mama said, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That's why you can't just give up on them, get mad with them. You ain't listening to them. They listening better than what you're thinking.
Yeah.
One thing, another thing about family is that they, family is very, I gotta say this here. Standoffish.
Yeah.
Standoffish, you know. They're there, but they looking.
Yeah. Right.
And they're waiting to see if what you're talking is gonna come to play. They standoffish. Come on, somebody. They're there. And they ain't too letting nobody mess with you now, but they just standoffish. Because you know they could talk about you, but boy, there's somebody else. But you what? That's my sister, what you talking about? Yeah, you know, they say little slick things, but nobody else.
That's what I say.
That's family.
Mm-hmm.
And they're standoffish. This is what they're waiting for. They are waiting to see the fulfillment of purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Success is a drawing card.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. I remember when I tell this kind of often here, and I remember I went to a Creflo Dollar church one morning. And I've been hearing him talk about him and his mother used to stay into it. Because when he came out of the Baptist church, she didn't come and she wasn't into the speaking tongue, laying on hand, casting devils out. So they stayed into it. Over, you know, the belief of that. She ain't no tongue talking, all that stuff. You just straight Baptist. Southern Baptist.
Yeah.
And they stayed for years. For a while. But one morning when I went, that they built the World Dome, I went there one morning. I was in Atlanta. I went by there. And I went to a certain section, and I looked up, and I saw the head usher. And I knew who it was. She looked just like him. He looked just like, exactly like her.
Wow.
Look exactly like Mother Dow.
Yeah.
I mean, you just look at that. Pretty look. And then she turned around and she, you know, just sweet as she want to be, you know. She's the head usher.
Wow.
But now, what drew her?
Mm-hmm.
Success.
Come on now.
Mm-hmm.
Your families will be the last one that come.
Mm-hmm.
You'll have some that'll come, that'll embrace. But most of them, a lot of them, they're going to be the last ones. They're going to send that way. James was one of the slowest ones to believe.
Yes.
Jesus' brother.
Yes.
He's one of the slowest ones to believe. Familiar.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, even Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Isn't that so? Mm-hmm. So don't y'all bug God and mad with them because they won't help me. They won't come. You just keep doing what you do.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
When I look at Kenneth Copeland and T.I.